I hurt because I felt like we weren't good enough.
Tiffany Allen and Angel Lane have been together for 7 years, and Lane had finally found a jumpsuit she hoped to walk down the aisle in.
But I just couldn't stop thinking about it. It was like the only thing that I found that I just fell in love with.
The company, based out of New York City, is called D. Auxilly. Tiffany reached out to get some information from the designer.
I know the jumpsuit is $1,500. Do you do any kind of payment arrangements, or what is your process? How does it work?
She was shocked to open this email. It says in part, "I wouldn't be able to make a piece for a same-sex wedding." She goes on to write, "I know you both love each other and that this feels right, but I encourage you both to reconsider and see what the Lord has to say and the wonderful things he has in store for you both if you trust and obey him." It's signed by a Dominique Galbraith, who, according to the company's website, is a celebrity designer.
So I have friends that are Christians. I know people of so many different walks of life, and none of them are hateful towards me and my fiance.
The women say they're still processing the response.
Well, true Christian people, whether they're Catholic, whether they're Baptist, it doesn't matter. A person that truly has that heart will tell you that God doesn't make any mistakes. And if God doesn't make any mistakes, then I'm not a mistake. My fiance is not a mistake.
St. Louis University professor of law, Marcia McCormick, says the company is breaking the law.
The dressmaker is violating New York state law, which prohibits discrimination on the basis of sexual orientation by what are called public accommodations.
To make the lines blurry, Missouri's laws surrounding the issue prohibit discrimination. But McCormick says that doesn't include sexual orientation.
It only prohibits discrimination on the basis of race, color, national origin, religion, and sex.
In the end, she says the law that would apply in this case is the one where the dress designer is based.
You don't have to agree with it, but you should respect it. And that was disrespectful.
Fox 2 reached out to the company to get its side of the story, but our emails went unanswered. And our attempts to reach out by phone and on social media did not get a response either. That couple says they plan to file a formal complaint against the company and will consider filing a lawsuit. Molly Rose, News 11.